Hacking has many different definitions and meanings, so many in fact that I can't even think of another word with this issue. And I'm certainly not fighting against these established definitions because you will always lose against the evolution of languages. It's okay for me that hacking in the public eye is negative, and I can accept that people participating in programming events call themselves hackers, and I also see why social engineering can be considered hacking. And I also know that these perceptions might change over time. I get all that, and that's fine. Human communication is ambiguous, and obviously I have my own definition as well on what I consider the correct way of hacking. But as I said, I won't disregard the other opinions, so let's actually not discuss this highly emotional word and just talk about why many of you watch my videos, and that is understanding computers so well that we can make them do stuff that was not intended. It seems like the rubber ducky is a big trend right now, at least on YouTube and Reddit. And I want to use that thing as a scapegoat to make a point. But before I get into my argument, let me quickly make something clear. The rubber ducky is a product sold by Hack5, and my criticism is not aimed at them advertising their products on their show. I have nothing but respect for them creating a solid product and building a successful company. I'd love to meet them, have a beer, and collaborate on a video.
We're not gonna get a takedown for that.
No, I don't think so.
My criticism is about something else. So, here's my rubber ducky tutorial. Rubber ducky is the name for a USB device that identifies itself as a keyboard. You can configure or program it so that it automatically types whatever you want. For example, you can use that to open a terminal and type in commands to create a backdoor or download and install a rootkit. Done. That's the whole tutorial. There's nothing else to say about this. I mean, when I heard that for the first time, my reaction was, huh, that's actually a pretty clever hack. This idea never came to my mind. But that's it. It's not sophisticated or interesting to me beyond that. Nonetheless, you find an endless stream of videos, blogs, and tutorials about this. The obvious reason for that is that it's so simple that anybody can understand it. And actually, it's a cool way to introduce kids to the concept of hacking or IT security. Like we give children Cosmos crystal growing kits for Christmas to get them excited and interested in science. But what real scientists do at a university is obviously completely different. Of course, the rubber ducky can be used by a professional penetration tester when going on site and trying to get a foothold into an organization by trying to slip that into a computer. But a big part of this job is not that technical. You know, tricking people into clicking on emails or acting like cleaning personnel to enter a server room is impressive, and not that easy. I'm certainly super bad at social engineering and acting, but is that really following the spirit of figuring out the magic of computers, how they work, how you exploit them? Not for me. You see, there are two ways you can approach learning about security. And most of these rubber ducky tutorials are result-based. I'm not that eloquent, so there's probably a better word for what I try to express. What I mean with result-based is that these tutorials are about how to extract clear text passwords with a rubber ducky, how to brute force an Android lock screen with a rubber ducky, how to start a reverse shell with a rubber ducky. But what do all these things have in common? They all rely on typing something on the keyboard. So if you come from the other side, if you learned the underlying concepts and principles, and you have a general understanding of the operating system, programming, digital circuits, protocols, and so forth, then it's clear that all this is possible. Specific tutorials for these things are not helpful. And when you come from this other side, you get much more benefit from it. For example, when you find a remote command injection vulnerability, you now understand what kind of commands you could use to get a reverse shell, and you don't need another tutorial on how to get a reverse shell from a command injection. And here is the predicament. Using a rubber ducky turns normal commands into a hacking attack. So if you want to learn hacking, you search for tutorials, you will obviously find these result-based explanations. If you want to learn it properly, the underlying concepts are hidden in standard literature and computer science courses that don't have the word hacking in it. That's why I strongly believe a good sysadmin or programmer has good chances becoming a good hacker once they change their mindset from building to breaking. And somebody who learns using all the Kali tools will have great results during penetration tests and will have a successful career, but it's a lot harder for them to combine the fragmented information they get from the different tools to the general underlying understanding. Now, that's an ideal. I'm not innocent when it comes to that. I will also use tools that I don't really understand just because it gets the job done. But that doesn't necessarily make me a script kiddie. If you use the Rubber Ducky and it makes you look into how to program your own USB HID device, you learn about Arduinos and how to program a microcontroller, you learn about the USB protocol and how to advertise yourself as a keyboard, then you are not a script kiddie. But if you just use it and go around and drop different payloads, you are not a hacker in my eye. But the criticism I had for hacking tutorials from earlier also applies to many of my videos. I could argue that teaching you about buffer overflows or format string exploits is the real deal and teaching you the principles, but that might not be the case. I wish I knew what Halvor Flake really said during one of his presentations. Unfortunately, there is no recording available, but what it says here on the slides hits deep. Halvor argues that we fail at teaching exploitation properly and instead teach a bag of tricks. That's kinda what I meant with result-based learning earlier. The broken exploitation curriculum looks like this. We learn about stack smashing, about specific heap implementation and how to exploit it, we learn about SQL injections, about ASLR and other mitigation, and we learn about XSS, and many more overly special cases. We have a problem that we are disjoint, disparate, and terrible at transmitting principles. Too many people miss the forest for the trees as a result. When you learn how to write a heap exploit and you become an exploit practitioner, you will probably develop the intuitions that is needed. You basically learn the actual underlying concepts from the fragmented information you have collected over time, but there is no incentive to formalize or disseminate the mental models. And we also not really have them at this point. I guess that is the main reason why we still teach in this way. But there's progress in that field. We started to formalize these concepts and develop the theory of weird machines and language theoretic security, but we don't have a full understanding yet. I met Halvor Flake once. He doesn't know me, but I told him that his research was a revelation for me. Basically, I understand now that we should approach exploitation also from the other side. He said, and I'm heavily paraphrasing here, I hope I don't misrepresent what he really said, that he talked to many people over the years who have written real crazy exploits in widespread software, and they have developed this formal intuition of what exploitation or hacking really is. For example, here's a guy who fuzzes browsers and has a lot of high value bugs to his name, reacting to the slide deck from which I have shown you a few pages. Simply wow. Halvor Flake makes explaining the seemingly random processes in my head when I write exploits look simple. For a script kiddie, different rubber ducky payloads may look crazy and like complicated hacking, but if you understand the underlying concepts, they are nothing special. So if we can also understand the principles of exploitation, all these memory corruption tutorials may seem trivial. I hope I can get there. I hope we can together develop this intuition. But I also hope smarter people than me who do research in this field can formalize it for all of us. That would be easier. Long story short, if you own a rubber ducky, use it as a motivation to go deeper. Don't be a script kiddie. Thanks for listening to my 2 cents about hacking. I'd really love to talk about this more, so feel free to express your views here as a YouTube comment or on Reddit. See you.